Spore has been such a long time coming, and there have been so many expectations leveled on the game that it's kind of hard to take a step back and actually just look at it as a game. I think it's useful to go back to Will Wright's original codename for the game, which was Sim Everything. It's a sim game, very much so, just like The Sims or SimCity. It's in terms of style and depth, it's very similar to those games. And it's also everything. It's basically a simulation of an entire species, an entire civilization, from tiny little single-celled organisms swimming around in the primordial ocean all the way up to that race's evolution as a spacefaring civilization. Spore is actually more like five short games that are kind of mashed into one sort of linear experience. You start out in the cell phase, swimming around in the ocean, just eating food and slowly getting bigger and more advanced. The gameplay here is basically just a lot of clicking. You click on the food that you want to eat, you click on other cells that you want to fight with to get bigger and stronger. Pretty soon you evolve into a land-dwelling creature, you crawl out of the ocean, you start organizing your species in packs, you start learning to hunt. Still a lot of clicking in this phase. You're basically clicking on not only creatures that you want to attack and eat, but also creatures you'd like to socialize with. So the gameplay gets just a little more advanced in the creature phase. It's still fairly rudimentary, however. In the tribal phase, your species has finally gained self-awareness, so it knows what it is and it's ready to organize itself into a basic society, basic social hierarchy. In this phase, you're interacting with other species who have reached the same level. So the gameplay gets a little more sort of real-time strategy style, where you're creating multiple iterations of your creature, they're gaining some basic tools, and they can, again, choose to either socialize with or fight with the other tribes. The goal of this phase is essentially to either make nice with all those other tribes or wipe them out so you can become the dominant species on the planet. Once you are that dominant species, you're in the civilization phase. This is where you're the most important and the smartest thing on your planet, and you've gained the necessary technology to spread across the planet and maintain, you know, communications and travel and commerce with different cities. The goal here is actually to unite all of your cities under one banner, one regime, one government. You've got different military and economic and religious tools that you can choose to do that with. You can create different sorts of land, air, and sea units that can either carry your message or your goods to other cities or your intention to destroy everybody. Finally, once you've united all the cities on your home planet, you're in the space phase. Your civilization has gained the necessary technology to get off the planet and get out there and start exploring nearby star systems. As soon as you do that, you're going to find that there are a lot of other sentient races out there doing exactly the same thing. So it's up to you to either make nice with them or trade with them or maybe make war with them to expand your own empire. You want to colonize as many planets as you can, build your wealth until you're basically the most prominent civilization in the cosmos. There's so much going on over the course of this 5 billion or so year journey that Spore spreads itself a little bit thin. There's so many different styles of gameplay being juggled from one phase to the next that it's kind of got this jack of all trades, master of none thing going on. No one of these phases on its own is extremely deep or complex, or lengthy for that matter, except for the space phase. But there's always the carrot on a stick dangling in front of you of you want to keep building up your creature and increasing its abilities and making it look cooler, and you want to see what the next phase is going to be about until you finally get to the space phase, which again is really where the meat is. The Aesop Spore sleeve is its creation tools. Right from the beginning of the game, you are in pretty much total control of how your single-celled organism looks. As you crawl out of the muck, you're slapping on legs and arms and horns and fangs and different sets of eyes. I mean, you're going around collecting body parts, and just about anything you can think of is in there to apply to your creature. On top of all those body parts, the game just makes it easy with really simple mouse controls just to morph the basic body shape of your creature. You can click and drag just to move vertebrae around to make your creature stand upright. You can scroll your mouse wheel to make body parts bigger and smaller. It's super intuitive and easy to get into. You can slap different kinds of paint jobs on there. It really just takes one look at the Sporepedia that EA has running online to see the power of the tools and what people have been able to do with them. Now obviously you're not playing Spore in a vacuum, you're not the only one making crazy creatures and vehicles and all that stuff, and the game makes it really easy to integrate other people's content straight into your game. Maxis obviously has made plenty of stuff, so it's right there on the disc if you're just going to play offline, but there's a pretty robust community feature and a browser that lets you look at any random person's creations if you want, and you can also add people to your friends list. And then the game will actually start pulling those creations seamlessly into your game. It makes it feel like a really sort of dynamic and organic experience as people are constantly creating new content and it's seamlessly sort of bleeding into your own experience. It might sound a little cliche, but Spore really is greater than the sum of its parts. You've got these very discrete phases of gameplay, some of which are better than others, but when you step back and you really look at the entire journey over 5 billion years that you've taken, you can really kind of see how one part led to the next and the decisions that you made manifested themselves later on. That actually factors directly into the gameplay because you've got a really nice timeline that shows up and down the progression of your species, all the little decisions you've made, the evolutions that you engineered in your physical form, later on the cultural and technological decisions you made. Those things actually pop up later in the abilities that you have in some of the more advanced phases of the game. Spore is a game with a lot of heart, and I think it's easy to like for that reason. You can almost feel Will Wright's appreciation for the scientific enterprises, you know, cosmology, evolutionary biology, that informed the idea and then the creation of the game. The creation tools within the game are satisfying enough on their own that that's kind of an end unto itself. You could waste hours just building wacky creatures and vehicles and buildings if you want, and then the community aspect that ties all that together hopefully will keep the single-player game interesting even after you've played through it once or twice. If you take all the disparate or the discrete sections of the game, I mean, again, this is basically sort of five games in one, none of those on their own would really hold up as a game, but when you cram them all together and you establish this sort of umbrella of evolution and just the path that a civilization takes from inception to basically its peak, Spore offers an experience that's really unique and basically something that you're not going to see anywhere else.